in my memory, was to see our classmate neighbor on her free calendar. When most of us who felt disturbance tried to make our way to after the year, as we're talking to you, you always have that odd one though. Mark Lewis. Greg. You know, he could lie and come on to be in the corner. Everybody was boss of her. Late that evening, every status you picked on, there was a chaos spread. The teachers also added to our excitement experience, like Mr. Parkinson, Mr. Smith, Mr. Watson, Ms. Cullen, and even Ms. Steele, our professor of the They always brought the vibe whenever we went. One person is about, which one of you has looked at any different about it? I must make mention of our native sister, Mrs. Alison Borman is one. Although we only experienced her leadership for a short time, she made a big impact. Ms. Borman. She was the epitome of discipline. She was one who did not feel disrespected. I remember when Alicia Gardner was talking in the bushel, when Principal Bumpy realized that, girl, talking like a fool as I talk. Principal Bumpy was also an enabler, as she never shied away from showing the school population all the thorough quality that she would have. And in regards to being present at work despite her health condition, taught her that no matter what adversity we face, we would be able to overcome.
Talking about being an amazing, we also had similar colors. Kitty. She was beautiful, intelligent, jovial, with a smile I'm sure we'll never forget. She always rose to any challenge. She competed and assisted with sporting matters, drama, and speech. That she was fully committed to school life. We wish she was still here with us. However, her presence will always remain in your heart. I am sure she would have been vying for the top recognition, as she was very serious about her academics. God, however, knows this. I hope her dad singing the sky. I hope her singing on the angel's harp. Stephen, we love you, and you are truly amazing.
No, let's talk about green. Why? The Big Bang COVID 19 started in March 2020. The government announced that school would be closed for 2 weeks. Clearly, they meant to stay for almost 2 years. It was evident that neither the country nor the education ministry was fully equipped or prepared for the transition to online school. So, our third form came to this journey, and yet, of course, after the break we had, because of the great pandemonium caused by the pandemic, the Ministry of Education and by extension, William Moon had a plan for an organized online school platform, which they tried to execute. We did not make that easy. If the classes were only 24, you can't come on all the way to be here. Some of us had internet issues, no devices, no services, and two my teachers started to say, but somehow just rely, not only about gossip, because they tried having school on this platform, as it is not easy to learn, especially in subjects like math, chemistry, physics, and other practical subjects online. I must make mention of one of the teachers who tried his best to make the most of this modality, Mr. Anderson. 7 days a week! 7 days a week, he had classes. He, especially in grade 9, I'm thankful, however, as most of us excelled in his subject.
We were given the opportunity to return to face-to-face school in grade 11, and we were absolutely overjoyed. Coming back to school, however, meant adjusting and adhering to the
We have accomplished great things, and we will continue to accomplish great things as we move diligently towards our future goals.
First up, Nisha Rahab.
Yeah.
Get in, because we accept you. We accept you. Romario Reed. Enrique Thompson. We're allowing the professional to redo it so you don't have to, you know, barricade the place to get your photo. Alright, so just wear this. Alright, that's it?
No, it's not it.
Asking the students of the 11th Anderson to get themselves ready. Thank you so much. Ahmad Anderson. Sounds like Ahmad to his whole community. Ahmad has a strong two invitations. Alright, that's Ahmad Anderson. Next up, Tajani Armstrong. Thank you. Speaker, Ms. S. Bognor. We will now present the graduates of 11 Nice Week. Making the presentation is the former teacher, Mr. Shreves. Shanilia Pekor.
Malik. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
All right, parents, all Thank you, Mrs. McKenna, for that presentation. Continue to enjoy your evening, graduates.
Of our school management team administrative, academic, and all other staff. You have molded and nurtured their minds and hearts so that they can be confident as they seek to face the future. We pray, O God, that as they go into the world, that you will guide them, protect them, God, from all harms and danger. Protect them, God, from the hands of the enemy. Lord, fill them with encouragement, hope, and stability as they seek to begin this phase of the journey. Give them strength and faith to step out and become ambassadors of peace in the world. And let it be, Lord, that each graduate will make some sense of positive change within our society. Help them, O God, to find their way with ease. Because you know, Lord, that this world can be described at times as a dark, deep, dark world. And so we pray, O God, that you will hold them by their hands and lead them into the way that you want them to go. Let it be, God, that every step of the way they will remember, like Jeremiah, that even before they were conceived in their mother's womb, you have a plan for them, a plan to prosper them, to give them hope and a future. So this evening, God, we place them in your hands. Bless them, guide them, watch over them, inspire them, protect them. Let it be, Lord, that each graduate will become a great man and woman of tomorrow. Into your hands we commit everything now, as we tell it that, through Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, we pray, and together we say,
Amen.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Before I begin my task, I'd like to acknowledge the presence of Mr. Dale Evans, the principal of the Holland High School. Thank you for joining us today. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for. Subject prizes and awards. The following students are being awarded for their outstanding performance in various subject areas and a contribution to school life. Krishan Woodburn, History, the H&A Macalot Trophy for the most outstanding title. Music. Malik Coleman, geography.
Thank you.
They never matter Sheila for academic excellence and exemplary conduct. The Ben and Lynn Hansen Cup for the students with the best CSEC result.
She's here. Additionally, Gratitude was extended to our graduation committee members who have worked tirelessly with us to ensure that this graduation ceremony is a success. We, the graduating class of 2022, are grateful to our principal, Mr. Lever Wright, vice principals, Ms. Justine, and Mr. Webster Thompson, as well as the teachers of our institution, for their commitment, hard work, and support throughout our academic years. Thank you for your words of encouragement, motivation, and acts of kindness. Thank you to the non-teaching staff that helped us through our challenges and created memorable school experiences as we grace the corridors of our new institution. Special thanks to all parents, guardians, and families who have invested their time, energy, and finances in ensuring that we made it to this very important milestone. We will never forget what you all have done. Thanks for accepting our invitations to come and see this graduation ceremony. Continue to show your love and support to us as we strive to become quality leaders of the future. Mr. Reigniting, Mr. Wainwright, Ms. Lorna Jackson, Reverend Smith, and other members of the William Knibb Baptist Church, we thank you for taking the time out to be a part of today's ceremony. Thanks to all stakeholders and individuals who work behind the scenes in one way or the other. Your contribution has not gone unnoticed. Last but not least, I would like to thank you, my fellow graduates, for attending this ceremony, specially prepared for us. Today's proceedings were a success because of your presence. I strongly motivate you to continue to make your presence known as good and meaningful citizens. Finally, I leave you with this quote by Helen Keller. Optimism is faith that leads us to achievement. Nothing can be done without hope and confidence. Have a productive remainder of the day. I thank you.
We are nearing the end of what can only be described as a very delightful time. Would you agree? Indeed, it has been delightful because it was conducted in a time or a space or a period of time that was not wearisome. For that reason, we need to be appreciative of those who plan, who choreograph this function this evening. It has been made delightful because of the presence, participation, and the presentation that we have received from you all. But I think it has been made delightful more so because of the hope and confidence. Because of the hope and the confidence that you have inspired in us. Because of the promise that you represent. We are confident that if you hold those positive values, reigniting them, allowing your lives to be guided by them and guarded by them, you will indeed deliver on those promises, and you will fulfill the hope and confidence that you represent. Thank you all for your presence and participation, and we now proceed to the session of the rites.
Take over. No, you're fully comfortable about it.